This is Duke University.
It can definitely be overwhelming. I think like the titles are super long, and sometimes people's research is very technical. So it's really interesting to see like the very diverse range of perspectives that we have here at the Visible Thinking Conference.
I've been studying pancreatic stellate cells, which are a cell type in the pancreas that secrete stroma that could be affecting the biology of neighboring cancer cells. And I looked at a specific pathway called the TGF-beta pathway and how activating that pathway in the stellate cells increases chemo resistance and epithelial to mesenchymal transition in cancer cells. And now I'm looking for a specific secreted factor in the media of the stellate cells activated by TGF-beta so that that could be a potential target for future treatments. that was a little stressful.
My research was on group progressions in vervet monkeys in central Uganda. I was in the field last summer in Uganda, and I studied who leads their group progressions. Is it leadership or consensus-based? And the results were that it's a bit of both. It's distributed leadership and partially shared consensus decision-making, where females lead the group most in foraging, and young nanomills also led the group because they're highly motivated to do so. You just have to get to the point, yeah. Every sentence is really important.
I was in Rome, Italy this summer studying party hostels and the abandonment of groupthink. I was at a hostel called The Yellow, and my hypothesis was that solo travelers from the Western nations would come and abandon groupthink, and my hypothesis was true. Often community norms were abandoned in lieu of high drug use, alcohol use, sexual promiscuity, openness about sexual promiscuity, and yeah.
So my research is looking at the psychological relationship between discrimination and health behavior preferences for African American individuals. Half of our participants were either primed with discrimination or not, and then half of them got an all-black health intervention pamphlet or an all-white health intervention pamphlet. We found that participants who were exposed to a discriminatory current event had more healthy preferences in response to an all-black health behavior pamphlet instead of the all-white health behavior pamphlet. The opposite was true in the absence of a racial discrimination prime, where we found that the white pamphlet got more healthy preferences instead of the black pamphlet. This leads us to believe that in communities that face higher degrees of discrimination and stigma, we might rely on identity-based interventions to reduce health disparities. But like doing it in the elevator, definitely a lot more quicker, and I feel like I just really want to get the results out as quickly as possible.
So have you heard of influenza pandemics? It's like swine flu, avian flu that can wipe out mass amounts of the population. So I really looked at the hotspot of Nepal in South Asia and how we can prevent this pandemic from even happening. So the way you can really do this is through surveillance, trying to find out where those cases are, through mHealth, such as using mobile phones, community health workers, and also using One Health. All flus come from animals into humans, so if we can prevent it in the animal host, we can prevent a pandemic from ever happening. It was definitely difficult. You work on something for, you know, maybe years and have to say it in 10 seconds, so.
Produced by Duke University.